Hello, this is Breuer, and welcome back to the episode of our Let's Play for Farming Simulator 2019. We are finishing up connecting these two big old giant fields here. We'll show you that here on the map in just a moment. Getting this plowed in, this last little strip here. We got the cultivator guy cultivating that lower field, and plowing, I guess, is maybe a better way, because he's actually doing some plowing for us. He's already got the top field done. That looks good. And here is our two fields joined up. You can kind of see them if you look at the total color. Just look at all the colors combined, and you can see all of our fields joined up into one big giant field. It's 21 and 22 here. We do need some lime, as I predicted, so I think that will be the next thing we do. Let's go ahead and drop off our plow somewhere. Take this back over to our house. And as I mentioned in the last video, you can see here at the bottom by the road, the workers have a little bit of trouble down here, so at some point we may push the borders of this field up a bit so they don't have as much trouble here. I forgot to go through my entrance here. And again, the plan here today, if you missed any of the first episode or anything like that, is we bought the biogas plant. This is the new Witchar map, by the way. We bought the biogas plant, and we are going to be doing a whole bunch of silage. So if you ever want to learn how to do silage the proper way, it's probably not the video for you, but I have a way to do it, so hopefully it works for you. Where do I want to put this? I'm sorry, I got distracted of where I want to stick this thing. I'm just going to stick it up against the wall over here. One thing about this plow is that it likes to fall over if you're not careful. We're just going to go in over here by the wall, by the water tank or whatever this tank is, and plop it there. Hopefully it stands up right. There we go. And now I will remember where it's at. Okay, we're going to go ahead and get us some lime, the lime container. Now we have these lime things down here. This one's 18,950. This one's 14,000. There's actually another one. It's just a little bit bigger. Is that one back here one as well? No, that's just fertilizer. There's another one as well. It's actually under the manure spreaders of all things. This right here, this Bergman, 25,000 lime we can put in this thing. And so I actually like this thing quite a bit. It's actually wider, plus it holds more lime. And why not? Let's just get this thing. And sure, we'll put Trelleborg wheels on it. Why not? By you. I mean, we may not need something this big, but it's done. It's wider, a wider path and everything like that. It makes things a lot easier. So let's go ahead and go over here. Continue to do our trick because hashtag YouTube video, let's save some time. I mean, I could drive all the way over and pick it up. Let's just pretend I did that. I put a cut in the video. I drove over, picked this thing up, and I decided to park it here instead of leaving it hooked up to my track. That's what happened. But there we go. So now we have this bad boy. And we're going to go get us some lime. We'll drive across our field because we don't care to destroy the crop. We're destroying it anyway. Interestingly enough, because we did just plow this crop under, we actually do have two levels of fertilization already on this field. So the fertilizer in the planter over there, we technically could remove it and just ignore it. But there's a few spots that are going to still need fertilizer, and honestly, it doesn't cost that much. So I'm just going to continue to leave fertilizer in for now because it's less trouble. But in theory, if you were really doing this, you wouldn't have to use fertilizer for those sections that already have double fertilizing done on them. Nope, not manure. Lime. This thing does let you buy basically anything in the game. Again, you have to pay extra. You have to pay like 15% extra if you're buying crops, and then 10% extra for like seeds and things like that, if I understand it correctly. So it's not cheap. It's not free. It would be cheaper if I went and bought it from the store. But again, this is so much more convenient, and I think it's worth the extra couple hundred bucks here and there. Not sure if I'm liking this GPS thing. I haven't used it yet, and I just don't know that I have a need for it. Honestly, it's so easy for me to just, like, if you look at, again, that bottom left-hand corner by the map, I could put myself at 180-ish degrees and go in a straight line without that GPS thing. So maybe I don't need it. Maybe I'll turn it off because the dots in front of my thing kind of are annoying, but we'll leave it on for now. It's not a big deal. Should be able to get all of this in one pass, I think. Unfold. Turn on. I think this gets everything. This guy decided to cultivate some of my plowed section, so I actually don't see what all I plowed, but I guess over here where he hasn't touched yet tells us where we're supposed to be. Okay, that's done. Oh, the whole field needs lime. Oh, I'm glad I got the big thing then. I was just thinking my new plowed areas would need lime. Literally everything needs lime. Well, that's easy enough to fix. I've got to turn the workaround for this. Just help you complete your task. Can you not do it down here? Seriously. Fine. I will do it myself. What do I pay you for just to sit there and tell me no? So disrespectful. I was gonna say I'm not quite gonna be able to get to the end. We are having trouble with the ends here because our tractors are too long. We'll just run along the bottom here, trim off that little bit, make it a little bit easier to go up and down. Let's turn here. A little bit of that corner. Excuse me, cars. Excuse me. Excuse me. I'm probably going to turn you off at some point. I mean, I'll leave you on for now because it's a little bit of ambience. Whoa, dude. Whoa. Honking at me now. That is really rude. You think they have, like, they don't live literally next to farms all the time. Like, they should be dealing with tractors on a daily basis. Honking. They don't honk at the workers when they're doing their stuff. They just honk at me. So, I think that's incredibly rude. Get our seeder going here in just a moment. Lots of seed. It's going to take a while, to be fair. Cedar might be one of those things. Well, I guess the cedar's a little bit wider. Definitely the cultivating guy, the cultiplow here that we have. I might get a second one of those at some point, because this part takes a long time, as you can see. And we have to do it after every crop. Corn is very destructive on the land, the field itself, the soil. And so you have to plow after every single corn crop. Definitely one of the downsides of corn compared to some of the other crops where you don't have to do it. You only have to do it like every third crop or something like that. But it's still going to give us a massive volume of chaff, which is what we need to make massive volumes of silage, which is basically printing money in this game. It will all work out well in the long run. Alright, there's all of our linemen. We'll double check here before I put this thing away that we are in fact good. Yep, no lime needed anywhere. Let's go put you away, sir. Fold you up. One thing I wish about this map is that I wish these openings were just a tiny bit wider. I mean, they're fine. They're plenty wide to get through here, but a little bit wider would be nice. Alright, let's back you up here. There we go. First piece of equipment. Done and you. Well, I guess second. Got the plow over there. But technically is done. Our worker over there is currently not working, but what I want to do before he does anything is I want to get up here and get our cedar going. Or I should say planter. My apologies. Slight difference. We'll get this guy rolling on the planting while we finish cultivating the spots that this other guy, for whatever reason, doesn't want to do. If we have enough money, we might buy that cornfield right there. That one that looks green right now, just south of this, what is this, wheat or barley, whatever. Once it gets a little bit higher, because that'll give us a little bit more chaff as well. It's not a lot, because again, it doesn't have, the computer guys don't typically plow or fertilize properly or do lime or any of that stuff. So the yields are usually quite a bit lower the first time you buy a field if it's got harvest on it or crop on it. But I think it'll still be worthwhile in the long run. All right, so unfold the sower. This is a big old wide sower. Very, very awesome. Back up just a smidge here. Get it lined up properly. Give him a little bit of overlap. It's going to be okay. Just to make sure he gets it all. I actually probably prefer a little bit more overlap than that even. Just to make sure. I hate for him to miss like a single line, and then I'm like, what do I do? I mean, I can ignore it because it's not really worth the time, but we'll do that. Make sure he's on corn. As soon as I hit the button, I was like, wait a minute, is he on corn? Yes, he is. He's on corn. He's going to be able to go through that. He's actually going to go all the way down to that bottom field. I do want to go ahead and cultivate this stuff down here, although he will probably stop just like this guy did before he actually gets down here. But just to get some of this locked in. He might get a little bit further down than that guy did. We'll see. I hope so. But if not, we'll do the bottom part ourselves later. What is that, potatoes? Potatoes always look so kind of cool with their little neat rows. Very, very neat, precise rows there. Now, the stuff that we plowed in to create the fields, we do not have to run this thing over because our seeder, or planter, I should say, using the wart word, our planter does the cultivating that's necessary for the planting itself as part of the process. So we don't have to actually cultivate after we plow, which is at least saves us a little bit of time and steps. As soon as we get this stuff planted, we'll be ready to fast forward some time. Get us to the point where we are ready to do our very first harvest. There we go. That's all done. See how far down he comes. Probably just to the edge of the white is my guess. Yep, just about, what, 3 yards, 4 yards? Oh, he's going to keep going. Oh, he stopped. I knew he was going to stop. I don't know why. Like I said, I will eventually probably just trim that back because I hate the fact that the workers, when I assign them to do something, they just give up. It's kind of annoying. But that's about the only downfall I've seen on this map so far, is that some of the fields are very close to the roads. All right, let's go ahead and park this bad boy. Scratch the paint on my trailer over there. Got two pieces of equipment. I've got to stick it as close as possible as I need, you know, whatever. No, I'm gonna have more equipment eventually, so worth parking as close as I can. All right, so that's done. This guy, just anything I can do with this guy at the moment? Run into a car. Not at the moment. I mean, I could always, like I said, give me another planter just to help this guy out, but he'll get through this pretty quickly here, so I'm not too worried about that. Just do some donuts out here. I do have an add-on called Real Dirt, I think it is, or something like that, which will actually make the dirt and other bits and grime and stuff like that on your tractors look more realistic. In fact, as you can see, as I'm rolling over this, you can see the white lime building up on my tires, which looks, in my opinion, pretty cool. If I was running over a bunch of grass, you'd see a bunch of green on here and things like that. So I think it definitely makes it look a lot more realistic and very, very cool. So have a neat little add-on. Not necessary, not critical, not mandatory, obviously, by any stretch of the imagination, but always fun to have little add-ons like that, that actually do stuff. Come on, planter, let's go. Let me help you pull. Go faster. All right, well, we're going to let this guy go for a little bit. I will probably fast forward some time. And actually, if I can remember, somebody mentioned one time before, why don't I start doing some time lapses? Well, it's a little bit more work for me to do time lapses. Let's see if I can do a time lapse correctly this time. You know what I'm going to do? I'm going to get me a piece of paper, an envelope, and I'm going to write down on this piece of paper, time lapse, because that's the only way I'm going to remember, at, we're at 15 minutes and 24 seconds in. All right, well, we're going to time lapse the rest of this bad boy doing his job. We'll be back when he's done. All right, we are back from our time lapse. Please let me know in the comments below what you think of that. It is a little bit more work for me, but you guys are worth it if you like it. Otherwise, I'll just do skips, you know, just pause the video and come back with skips and things like that. But if you prefer the time lapse, let me know, and I can definitely do some more of those going forward. All right, let's go ahead and drop this bad boy off. Actually, what we're going to do real quick, because I'm trying to get in the habit of doing this, is I'm going to go ahead and fill this thing back up so it's ready to roll for the next time we need it. This guy filled up real quick. And honestly, I might actually even just park it up here. There's no reason to take it all the way back to down there if we don't need to. Get some fertilizer, which we don't really need that much of, but it's all right. Put the seed right there. No, honestly, we're just going to park this thing right here. Going to be just fine. Come on, back up. Let's go. There we go. All right, so that's done. Let's check our fields, make sure they are ready to roll. Look at that. Corn all the way up and down. Currently in the first stage of growth. Fully fertilized most of the places. Just a few places need a little bit more fertilization once the first stage of growth comes in. Or the second stage, I guess, if you want to call it that. Once we get a little bit of the green stuff coming up, we will go ahead and go do a pass of fertilizing these last few little bits. And that is that. Let's check this other field over here. So the field over here is it's in its second stage. So we still got a couple more stages before we can harvest that if we decide to buy that field. How much is that field if we do decide to buy that? 155. Oh, that's a lot of money. I still think it might be worth it. We will find out. But for now, we are going to go ahead and do another quick fast forward here to fast forward some time. I'm probably not going to time lapse this one because it's going to be boring me just sitting here waiting for stuff to grow. So This one I will actually put a pause in, and we will be right back. All right, we are back from fast-forwarding a little bit. As you can see, we've got our first stage of growth on our cornfield here. So that does mean I can go ahead and go and fertilize the little strip there and the bottom part where we plowed in some extra. So we'll do that here in just a moment. One thing I do want to go ahead and do real quick is I haven't actually given you a tour of the biogas plant and what it entails. The spot I'm standing on right now is the digest it spot. You know, this is where the digest it gets made, and it just looks absolutely revolting and disgusting down there, as you would expect. What is digest it? Digest it is a bit of fertilizer that we can get, and that comes from this little spout right here. As we dump stuff into the silage plant and it consumes it, it then makes us some digest it that we can use to fertilize our fields effectively for free. We do have to get a special machine for that, but we may or may not explore that. We'll see. But here is, as you saw earlier in the previous episode, we put down our silos here. And the way this works is you see fill level chaff equals zero right now, and compacting equals 0% in the top left corner. We fill this thing with chaff, which is just the broken up, you know, harvest. Instead of actually harvesting, we just chop everything up and it becomes chaff. And we dump it in here, and then we roll over it to compact it with our tractors. And, you know, once we get to 100% compacting, we can lay a tarp or a sheet of plastic or whatever it is over the top of it, and then the fermenting begins. Once the fermenting completes, which takes, I think it's like 6 to 8 hours of game time, something like that, which we will obviously fast forward through most of the time, we can then uncover it and start dumping the silage into this little dump spot. And the silage actually does look like this. It's kind of interesting to have a little bit of a silage look here. That's kind of what it looks like. We dump it here, and as you can see, there's a little counter there that says zero currently. You can only dump up to 50,000 liters at a time. And it takes about an hour, I think an hour and 15 minutes or so, something like that, to consume that 50,000. And so then you just gradually continue add throughout the day. And then at the end of the day, you don't get any money throughout the day. At the end of the day, at 2,400 hours, or 0 hours, whatever you want to, whichever side of that coin you want to look at, it gives you all the money that you've consumed or you've built up for the day. And then at that point, you also get the digested over here. So we'll play with that a little bit more once we actually get the silage coming in. But I just kind of wanted to give you a little bit of an idea of what's going on here. Let's get us a, what am I looking for? A big old giant fertilizer thing. I think we're going to go with the New Holland over here. Hashtag channel colors, because why not? We'll go with this bad boy. I'm not going to do the global positioning system on this one because I think I'm going to turn it off. I don't think it's necessary. I think with the degrees in the bottom left-hand corner, I don't know that I'll ever use it. If you guys know of a use that I'm just missing, let me know. But until then, we're just going to grab this bad boy. I will go ahead and bring it over here. Come on, select you. Select. There we go. Let's go ahead and bring it over to our spot. Jump in it. And we'll come up there and we'll get us some fertilizer. Cool thing about this is that it does have the tiny wheels, as you can see, built in. And it's also incredibly wide. It's like 32, 36 meters, something like that. I guess we could have looked. Let's see. What is it? It is 36 meters, if you look in the bottom left-hand corner down there, which is one of the biggest ones. I mean, this one's 41. This one's 48.5. But 36 is plenty big. We're going to be just fine with this one. And again, it's close to channel color, so we'll go with that. This thing can do both fertilizer and herbicide, just like any of the other ones like this, so that'll be good. We might actually get two of these, just so we don't have to keep swapping what's inside them. We'll deal with that one when the time comes, though. All right, fill up on fertilizer. Down to $300,000. Ooh, it's getting close. It looks so funny with the big old giant arms on the front of it. All right, our crossover is right here, isn't it? Where the road used to be. Yes, I can see. This should be it. All right, go ahead, turn on. Let's go. I'll go forward. There you go. You can do it. and do this, and then we'll do the bottom right-hand corner down there where the woods were, and then we'll be good to fast forward again, I suppose. That field over there is still not in its final stage yet, so we're not going to be consuming that just yet, but I'm going to keep an eye on it. Like I said, there's a good chance that I will pick that up. I think we'll still have enough money to do everything we need, even if I buy that field. Worst comes to worst, if we don't, I can just sell the field right back and get that money right back, so that's not a big deal. But I think we'll have enough. Come on, bag it up. Bag it up. Let's go. Zoom out a bit so I can see the both sides of the arms very well. I don't remember exactly where this one starts, so we'll just kind of start a little bit early and just a little bit extra fertilizer, not going to hurt anything. It might get end-to-end. I'm not sure. I think we're okay. We'll check the map here in a second. There's that. Nope, it did not. So we're going to have to do just a smidge more over here. Not really a problem. Fertilizer's not too expensive. Especially not at the race that we're going to be using it. So we should be okay. Alright, let's get this dumped off here. And... sorry about that. Had to put a quick cut in the video. Had somebody at the door. Alright. Let's see here. That is good. We're good there. So at this point, we're really just going to be fast forwarding again. So we are going to go ahead and put another pause in the video. Again, because this is boring. Me just sitting here waiting for stuff to grow. Part of the video, so I don't think the time lapse will be as good on this part, but again, there's a good chance we will be buying this field over here soon, and it is about, yeah, it's on the third stage, looks like. Yes, so we have one more stage to go, and then we might be able to start getting us some silage from that field, so we'll see. You guys will be back in just a moment. All right, we are back, and as you can see, it is nighttime currently. I'm going to try to do as little footage at night as possible, although I think some footage at night is probably a little bit unavoidable, just various reasons. One thing I will go ahead and do, though, because I think it's cool. This is a great add-on. It's going to really help us out a lot. It's under miscellaneous. Nope, it's under decorations, I think. There we go. We're going to grab some of these big old giant automatic lights, and we're going to plop these down over here. Where's our... oh, I was like, I'm out of position. I'm going to come up here to this area. And I'm going to pop some of these bad boys down around here that we're going to need. I'll probably just put them back up against the fence. I can see the fence. Barely, right about there. I guess it's where it turns green. I'm going to plop some of these guys down. Give us a little bit extra light. These things are amazing. Could not purchase. Why not? Try again. There we go. I just guess I was just a little too close to the fence or something. We'll put a couple of these guys out on the edges of our property here. Come on. You can do it. Come on. You can do it. Why can you not be purchased? It's green. There we go. I don't want to get too close because I want to be able to run a trailer up through there. I guess we could put it up over here against the fence back this way. Just to give us a little bit more light. A couple of these things do have light. It's cool that this silo has a little bit of light. That's very convenient. A little bit of light there. We'll put some up here maybe. We can fit one in back here. Looks like we can. There we go. Not too bad. I mean, they had some of these lights right here that are shining. That's helping a little bit. But that's going to help quite a bit, I think. It's going to help us see quite a bit better. All right, we'll go with that. And then what we're going to do is we are going to go ahead and buy field 28 over here. I think we have enough money to be able to do it. Plus, let's get a little bit of silage started right away. So we're going to go ahead and hit select lands. Go ahead and select it. Buy it. It's currently in the final stage of growth, which is exactly what we want. So now we're going to go ahead and buy us our forage harvester. Not an actual regular harvester because we're not harvesting the corn. We are foraging the corn. Let's see. Last time on my personal game, I used this Big X 1180. I could try out this Kloss here. Might be kind of cool. Because it's new and it's in the game, and why not? Don't know if it really matters. Pipe. Do think I like the long pipe if I can do that. Again, I'm going to leave the global positioning system off. Yeah, we'll go with this one. Why not? Is there a... It's not a New Holland, is there? There is, but it's yellow. So nah, we're not going to use the yellow New Holland. And between the two of these, I mean, we'll go with the one with more horsepower, right? Why not? Let's go for it. Hopefully this works out the way I want it to, because I know the other one works. I just don't know if this one works, how well this one works. But we'll try it. And we'll lease this bed about $24,000. It's crazy. And then we need to get us a header. And we'll need a forge harvester header. So, looks like these are the Kloss ones, and we want the one that does corn. 9 meters wide. The one I've been using with this Krone X-Collect 900 is also 9 meters wide, so that's good to see that we are not shrinking down anything at all. Let me just make sure there's nothing else new over here. Nope. We'll go with this bad boy. 7.5 and 9 meters. There's two of them. 9 meters is going to be just fine. Is that thing really called the Jaguar? I had not noticed that. It is. That's so cool. I like that name. Then we're going to need a trailer. And there's a bunch of different trailers you can use. You can use... I think these things will connect to just regular rear dumping trailers. But honestly, the biggest trailer you can get that works for this is a sugarcane trailer. It's going to be one of these Randons here. 66,500 silage that we can put in this bad boy. Plus, it turns on a dime. It's going to be great. So let's change the color. I mean, I've been making things channel colors, but I forgot the cloth stuff. We might as well make it match our cloth things, right? I don't know what color rims we want. What is a cloth color? What's the other cloth color? Not that it really matters, but now I kind of want to make it match. Cloth is white. Oh, red. Red is their wheels. Okay. We can do that. Come on. I don't know why. Just got a bing. That's odd. All right. Sugar King technology. Any of these will work. If you do these can actually connect to each other. There's actually a hitch on the back here. So you can connect two of these together and just run a train. But there's no reason for us to do that because this thing right here is already bigger than two of those together and ultimately just going to be easier to maneuver with. So we're going to go change the color, go to class, change the rim color, go to... is it one of these? Ah, there we go. Probably that. There we go. That's going to match our tractors just fine. And we will lease this. And we're actually going to do something interesting. We're going to lease two of these. And you're like, why are you leasing two of these? That way we could dump one off while we have one running. It'll make more sense once we actually get into the swing of things. But that will be just fine for us. Okay, so let's... what am I looking for? Let's go to the map. Reset all this equipment because... Who wants to take the time to drive it? You guys can just pretend I paused the video and I drove it over here. Nobody has to say a thing. All right, let's jump into this big old bad boy. Get some lights on here. 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 lights. Perfect. And we'll go ahead and hook up to this first one. Oh, let's get their header first because it'll be a little bit easier to maneuver around and pick up. And then we can pick up the trailer. Gonna get this started and then we'll probably put a cut in the video because I just kind of want to see you guys show you guys how this works a bit. Grab you. I like this thing's not as fast as that other one I normally use, but it'll be all right. We'll make it work. Same kind of thing with this field, I believe. It doesn't like going to the very edge over here by the road. So we will probably trim that off first and then get the work going after that. And he'll fold this big old giant header here. I mean, it's not as big as like a normal harvester header, but it's still pretty big. We'll go ahead and get the pipe coming out. Cool thing about the pipe is that you will see, if I swivel a little bit here, it chases the trailer. It just turns and follows the trailer no matter where the trailer's at. So it's definitely very convenient. This thing also maneuvers pretty well, all things considered, especially with that trailer that has the front kind of pivot. All right, let's go. And we're going to turn on... actually, I need to go here. We need to... what is this? Everything. I think I have everything ready. So we will lower the header, turn on the harvester, and go. And we should start seeing some chaff going in the back there. So there you go. That is chaff. Chaff, again, is just their name, and maybe it's the normal name for it. I mean, I don't know as much about real-life farming as I should, but a chaff, for all intent and purposes, is the chopped-up crop. Yeah, it includes the stems, the leaves, and the crop itself all together. So presumably the reason corn is so good is because it grows so tall, so you get a lot of the stuff at one time. Oh, there's weeds on here. I don't know if that makes a difference if there's weeds on it at this point in the harvest. I actually don't know. I'll have to check our other field, see if there's weeds over there too. We'll do this first pass, and then we'll get it going horizontal. All right, we'll get the worker going. And we're definitely going to fill up this trailer before we finish this field. So what we're going to do is we're going to grab, we might as well grab the cloth because it fits the colors of the trailer. And we'll go over there and pick up the other trailer so that we can swap it out, keep that guy going, and we'll bring the new trailer, you know, the other full trailer over here to dump out. So I guess I should turn on some lights. But we're going to go ahead and put a cut in there. When we come back, we will probably have most of that field harvested by then. And actually, I'll probably come back when we're ready to dump our first load, and I'll show you that, guys, that. So we'll be back here shortly. I do appreciate you guys watching. May God bless you, and I hope you join me again next time. Thank you, and goodbye.